This shape kind of looks similar to the first proof that we dealt with. We've got two triangles and they share a side length. However, the given information is different. We've got these segments, let's call it MA and HT. Those segments are parallel, right? That's what that little arrow means. And parallel lines always, always, always give us angles. So these parallel lines are cut by a transversal to give us these two angles. So those two angles are congruent. Now, furthermore, these segments have these congruence tick marks on them. And as a result, MA and HT are also congruent. So they're both congruent and they're also parallel. And then finally, we've got a shared side up the middle, segment AT. And I know those segments are always congruent to themselves. So we can prove that these two triangles are congruent using the side angle side theorem. Right, we've got the green side length, the red angles, and the blue shared sides. So we're dealing with side, angle, side. So let's piece this together. First, we know MA is parallel to HT, and we also know that MA is congruent to HT. All right, so let's talk about those green sides. We know MA and HT are congruent, and that's given information. Next, we want to talk about the two red angles that we had. We had angle MAT and angle HTA. But why is that true? Well, that's true because of this given information, the two parallel lines. So we have to mention that fact. So the fact that MA is parallel to HT, if we have parallel lines, then alternate interior angles are congruent. So I know it's a bit abbreviated, but that reason, right, the connector with the arrow says if parallel lines, then alternate interior angles are congruent. And then finally, we have the blue sides. We have segment AT, and it's a shared segment. And shared segments are always congruent. Now, we're not quite finished with this proof. Yeah, we've proven that the two triangles are congruent, MAT and HTA, but that's not exactly what we're trying to prove. We want to prove that angles M and H are congruent. In other words, we want to prove that these angles are congruent, H and M. Well, in order to do that, we're going to use the CPCTC. See, once we've established that the two triangles are congruent, then all of the parts of the two triangles are congruent. That's what CPCTC stands for. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles are also congruent. And so we can say, given the fact that triangle MAT is congruent to HTA, that means angle M must be congruent to angle H. And now we're done with the proof.